tell you what's noteworthy about this, considering I've got through 3 flybacks and a few different circuits for this to get, you know, just what I want to call a modern, well, a nice looking little Jacob's ladder, or this type of effect, this electron plasma ring. I'll give it a little thing like this, it gets it going a bit better. And I've got quite a few circuits trying to get one that gives me a thing that I can just leave on and look at it like a half hour to an hour later and just do a little bit of a heat check. There's no fans or anything. And this is like, it's not much warmer than the air around me. It's not making, it's not doing any hard work at all. You can leave this thing on for long periods of time. And I think that's noteworthy. I must admit, it's not the biggest gap in the world. The thing's only 1.5 inches. I'm not going to put a tape measure there because the only thing I've got is metal. I've got a tape measure here. Well, it's not a tape measure there, so you can't see it. There you go, but it's metal, so I'm not using that. I suppose I could put this in, come on, and measure the gap like this, and then put a tape measure next to the bits. So it's on the, like, the tip to do this little lineage here. Where's the, well, again, it's the right way around. So from there to there. Oh shit, I forgot where it was. Oh, I'm gonna say from there to there. Well, there's that line, and from there to that line is. Yeah, 1.5 inches, like I called it. Excellent.
It is, can you see that? 1.5 inches. I can't hold it very straight.
Alright, there we go. Yeah, this thing's been running for ages. I've watched 2 Dr. Short's physics thingies on, they're not about 20 minutes each. That's 40 minutes, man. Yeah, this one's cold. It's not cold, but it's not hot. It's nothing that I think, oh, that's going to cause a problem. In actual fact, this is wax in the end here. And the other ones, I always had them dribbling out. Just at this same sort of, a little bit less than this. I don't know if it's because I've got more capacitance now. I've got 3, 2 of them are 0.3 mic, and one of them is 0.33 mic. And 2 are rated at 800 volts, and one's rated at 1200 volts. It's not like that on purpose, that's just how we got the capacitors, isn't it? Lock them together, and it's been running for ages. And because the camera's shit, the camera don't pick this up. Oh, sorry, the camera's not very good for the end. The camera don't pick it up very well, but it looks awesome in there. It's like a big chunk of it has got all the lights and effects going on. In different colours, but starts off real nice hot. That's been going for ages. I can leave that on the night, I reckon. Well, it's not all the night, all the night.
Cancels out a lot of the flicker, even though there is flicker quite a big one now. No, that's a flicker, not like.
Hey, does anyone know what I can do about these little LED lights that have this flicker? Let's try and. Oh, you can't, it's the camera in it. Oh, shut up. something else I noticed as well, and if anybody's listened to any or watched any of these videos where I've done a bit of the Jacob's Ladder thing before, you could always hear the power supply whining away. There'd be more noise than what that does. Or I should say making more noise than what that does. Sorry, I've had a couple of few beers. So the power supply is silent apart from the fan. And that's a big change. That's a big change. This is all noteworthy after taking off this piece of metal from around the flyback. Now I know you can't see that even though I'm waving it in front of the camera. But you might be able to. Yeah, that little bit of metal there that lives on the flyback. I'm gonna flip that light on. Oh, guys. That bit of metal. You take that off. And then put your turns on, and that keeps everything cool. The power supply shouldn't whine so much. A bit more capacitance is good as well. But that's like just, that's a cup of tea that you wouldn't drink. It's too cold, it's too cold. And the front's the same. Couldn't do this before. Used to run them for a while, it would be getting too hot. In some of my videos you might have seen I've actually put fans trying to keep the damn things cooler. But now there's no fans, no nothing. Awesome. And there's nothing special about it, it's the Mazzini Mazzini. Oh, I wish I could remember his name. It's our little circuit there. The same one on the interweb. Mazzini. Zero voltage switching. That's and just copy that. Just do that. I've put 260 ends, the MOSFETs, rather than 250s. And I've got three capacitors there. I'm gonna, I've already set it. 2.3s and 1.33. One's 1200 volts, that's the 0.33, and the 2.3s are 800 volts. It's just old flyback. Nothing special. And look at the wax, that's just wax out of a candle. It's not even melting because it's not getting warm enough. All my other ones melted. Glad they stuck to the board, the other ones used to get that warm with less power than this. So that's definitely noteworthy for anybody that's been having getting too warm problems or anything. I've got six turns, you can see six aside. I don't know if you know that helps anyone. I can blast it up. It's only getting, you know, well, just over 4 amps. 15 volts. You can energize it, but I just don't see the point in, like, you know, kicking the crap out of the flybacks all the time and just killing them. But maybe it won't happen though. Maybe I should give it a bit more power. If we turn that off and turn this on, and just up the. Up the voltage a little bit, because that'll make it work a bit harder. And then we give it some current to go with that. See what it does with that. Oh. See, even though you get that sort of stuff, looks pretty cool. Especially if I. But it's just going to kill my flyback, it's going to kill my everything about it. It's a pity when it was looking to be the best, you know, I was like, pulling the goddamn camera around, but I still haven't got that in the view like I had it before. I don't know what I've done. I didn't move the camera, I didn't move the what I stand it on. Which is just a torch. I don't have any proper camera stands or anything like that. I don't even know that. I just like fucking about with this stuff. Should we get some more power up there? So we have a little. And still, my power supply used to whine like crap. But now it doesn't whine like crap now. I can't keep doing that though, because that'll. You know, that'll upset it, it's got to. You know, I'm not telling porkers here, there's no real noticeable change. No. Right, that is a definite, that is absolute definite. That goes, there's absolutely no way before that the other flyback wouldn't have really heated up. That is no real difference to what it was before I give it that little bit of extra juice. It should have by rights, because it's still going up to just under five amps when it wants to, or just over 5 amps there. But, you can see it as well. Good. I just looked at it to make sure you can still see it. It's still. You couldn't drink that as a real cold cup of tea. I mean, that is just off cold. It's not. Oh, I can't just off cold. It's no warmer than me. It's no warmer than me. Front and back. Coil and then coils prime or secondary. I like this stuff. No. The caps will be fine. I just don't want to touch them because. I've just pushed them in the top of the holes. I haven't bothered to one of them screwed in, but the other two are just dropped on the top, so I can take them off and put different capacitors on and see what they were like. That's pretty good. Brilliant, now I have definitely got my little ornament that I can just run, and I can govern how many watts I want it to use just by dropping that down a little bit. Look, took a bit of the amperage away. And that's just as good. Now it's peaking, what, 4.5? I don't know what it is, but if I go into another room and come back in here, I don't smoke or anything, so there's no smoke around the house. But when I come back in here, it smells fresh, like at the seaside fresh. Which is quite bizarre. Maybe that's because it's a sunny day or something and the ozone, ultraviolet ozone, lots of stuff, but yeah, awesome. So I figured I'd share that because that is now a little, if anybody wanted to build one of these and you're finding you get overheating problems, yeah, I reckon if you do, like, yeah, let's just give it a bit more welly again. Okay, so we've been up in voltage, let's go up to like 18 volts or so. It says you can run these quite happily, normally at like 24 volts. But can your flyback take it? That's the problem, isn't it? Can the flyback take it? Get a bit more amperage. Don't want it just doing that though, I suppose. Because what's the maximum it can do? I like it going up and down. Well, okay, not, but a continuous cycle. So the noise going, it just does that. Should I touch it? I don't know, I don't think that's such a good idea. because I would feel a fool. So let's have some of this. It's, that's getting really hot. What's happening here? A little bit warmer, I suppose. Not really much difference, but that's definitely getting really hot, and I can imagine my cables will also be getting really hot. So I'm going to settle that down, drop down that voltage. That's it. No, they're not. They're really, really cold. They're just like as it should be. No, like they've been on at all. Well, look, I don't know what it's like for everybody else with these things, but I'm quite confident that I can run that a little bit more power. And just like leave that happy going on. I'm going to take down a little bit of the ampage, a little bit of that, just because I like that effect. And that's just my personal preference, but that's just not. Oh no, I lost one of my questers. Look, put it back in. There we go. Flipped it. MOSFET's cold. Heat sink's cold. Yeah, everything's cold. Well, it's just not off. What's the temperature now? I've got to wait for that clock to cycle. 23.11. 23.12. Just change that for 19C, I reckon. Oh, it's quite warm for 19C, but and it's not far off room temperature. Power supply's not making dodgy noises. And I know I've rabbited on about this for ages, but I think this as well. Well, we'll take into consideration that there is a definite difference if you take this bit of metal. Oh, where's the one I've got sort of areas? If on your flyback this is taken out of one, but if on your one where it's connected like it is there, take this bit off here. Take this off, this bit of metal, get rid of that. Ding. Off it comes nice and easy. There's a little bit of glue down the edges. Get a little tiny screwdriver and just crack away at the glue. Nice and gentle, you don't want to break this. And then you can just get this out. The glue might be up here as well. Either in, oh shit, I'm not even showing you. The glue might be there, or it might be there, and it might be there, and just gentle with a little screwdriver, get that off. Runs a lot cooler, runs just cold, doesn't get hot. With this there, I think the coils around it makes it like an induction heater, and it starts heating this up, and it everything starts getting too warm, and it's not really good. That's like room temperature, just leave that running. No worries about burning out the flyback at all. Where before it was a constant check, turn it off, leave it off for a while. I just don't like getting caught up there too much. Maybe I should make it a bit wider. I could do that. Look at this. This would be easier to move because it's hotter. It's the negative run. Now, notice that as well, it's the negative side that gets discoloured more so than the positive side. This is the positive look of the flyback coming out, and this is the negative. And it's always this side that gets charcoaled up. I wonder if that's because the electrons are doing shifting from a negative, jumping across to the positive. Did the positive jump across to the negative, or is it just the negative go towards the positive? But still, on the negative it seems to get hotter. That because I can tell one, because it's a lot easier to bend. Yeah, and then this one just flicks back a bit. Not so much easier to bend. That one a lot easier, it stays there, and just bent back. does look nicer, doesn't it? It's got a bit more. I do that when I do that by it, it's just to shift the air, just to get it moving a bit. I don't want it just sitting there doing that. That's 50 watts. So really I should expect this to get hot now. Yeah, it's a little bit warmer. In some spot, right in the middle it's warmer. I just don't think that's as efficient, I don't think that's as nice as when you see when it's like that. Still pretty young. Back down to about 5 amps peaking. So I quite like that. Just so it lasts longer. And I don't have to use so much power doing it. Nah. A little bit warm on the front. But nothing to worry about. But I wouldn't have it burning up like that, I don't see the point. I like the idea of having a bit of an ornament. 22 minutes, I can't believe it. I'm really sorry, alright, I'm going. Bye. Hey, thanks for watching.